Today's sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington.
I haven't played the Steelers in a while.
Here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up with Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Returning from his end zone is Ray McCloud. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Play action. Now Roethlisberger. He'll buy some time right. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation.
And him running the football is not something that defenses spend a lot of time preparing for, but this guy has a survival instinct and a knack for knowing when exactly to do it.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and 9. Roethlisberger will throw. He's going to launch it for Washington. And a high throw there.
Boy, I pressed Y with Parsons. He just jumped on him.
An early message that this secondary is going to be.
It looks like Roethlisberger's limping too.
It almost felt like a warning.
They added a limp to the game.
On is the punt team now as this one set away.
That was a long ass punt.
Oh, the return is Lamb. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and 2. On the counter, Elliott.
Oh, that would have been nice. I was hoping he'd switch to him right when I
juked. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they're in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front and linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Eluding the pressure right. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard. Shotgun, it's Prescott escaping the pressure right.
Ooh.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
As a former defender, I can feel their sigh of relief after that one, because when he breaks out of the pocket and you face a mobile quarterback, he causes all kind of problems in your secondary. They were able to force that incompletion.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. Elliott a first down and more. And all the way down to the 17-yard line. Had a chance to maybe limit them to 3 if they could have gotten that stop there, but a new set of downs.
And with a new set of downs, you got to take the mentality of the whole thing. Right now, everyone's looking at the offense and saying,
that's the first play. I didn't double him. And I ran away from him. He threw his guy down. Was able to dive and
chance to make a play ourselves.
It's crazy.
Maybe change things up.
I knew I should have passed. Whenever you show like the like you're chewing the clock the first time or whatever, a lot of times people just blitz because they assume you're running. So just throw. Now Prescott. He look. Oh fuck! I fucked that up. Still got a touchdown.
It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown. Amari Cooper there to make the grab, and the Cowboys have taken the early lead. Both sides of the football in sync early. You force the three and out, and then you take it down, score points.
You know what that tells me? They sold their game plan really well. Head coach said, listen, we're just going to stop them on three and out. We're going to take the ball downfield and score. But he also told.
And this is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Boy, so they don't get the conversion, but they're going to go right into the onside kick formation. And this doesn't work. The Steelers recover it. So an onside kick fail in the first quarter. Not sure I completely see the logic there.
It's not apparent, is it? You almost have to go deeper, I think, and maybe if we try and work along with them and speculate a little bit here, they must feel like they need to steal possessions in this game, and maybe they don't match up possession for possession with the opposite team. They've got to steal it and try and gain an advantage, and they tried. They just didn't get it done.
First down, and they go back to Harris. A nice little juke. 6-0 our score after one. A first opportunity for the Steelers in the red zone. They've got a first and 10 at the 17. And he'll get 7 yards from the 17 to the 10 before he's taken down.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Throwing on second and three, Roethlisberger flushed out right, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Micah Parsons, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And the Cowboys are going to have it here at their own 15. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one. Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line. In pregame, get used to the ground shaking with those big behemoths starting to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
A first down carry by Elliott. 47 yards on the ground for him so far. 4 yards remain for second down.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
Third and short yardage, Prescott. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. Devin Bush coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it also brings up 4th.
They can't stop us, baby. Every time it's a set. Come on, fellas. I'm going from back to you.
Fourth down, Prescott. He finds his man complete.
This is just ran in place for like he was wading water on the grass for a long time.
Fourth
and there was no one guarding the seam on the other side.
Definition of frustrated. You get them to fourth down, and then you allow a chunk play like that in the passing game.
Almost felt as if that play was drawn up in the dirt on the sideline. They pulled that from a game plan that wasn't this game, and they still made it work.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Hey, you have to double Hayward every play.
This time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. Tenth carry now for Elliott. Just a couple yards shy of the end zone. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. And he'll take it into the end zone.
I'm double running, it still hit me. What's it doing?
Ezekiel Elliott, as the first half is winding down, and the Cowboys will extend their lead here just before halftime. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And this is caught at the 5.
Bill Collins.
He'll get into the end zone to extend the lead by 2 more. And that's something you almost never see nowadays. When you fake it, you're at the 15-yard line on a PAT as opposed to just going for it from the 2.
I'm sorry. I know they got it, and congratulations to them. But it's just not a good play. I mean, the risk-reward is really off the charts. Not in your favor. Run your offense out there. Put it on the 2-yard line if you want to go for 2. But I'll be darned. They ended up getting that one, didn't they?
And an anxious moment or two there, but they do get him down. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. And how about this one?
I don't know why I thought he might. Sounds like it.
The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter 3. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you know, that both those special teams coordinators. They sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Powers through it, and he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 80 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. On play action, Prescott. Rolling to his right, and he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. On second down, it's Elliott, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.